Hello, I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. Today we're just finishing up an install. This house is out near Stillwater, Minnesota. It was built in 2005 and had an initial radon level of 3.5. So this one's got a little bit of nuances, so we'll kind of go through those. The first thing you'll notice is we've got the garage here. We've got a bonus room above the garage, which meant that we couldn't really get to the house attic because it's a two-story house. So you typically don't find closets that will line up. And our house is over there, so we had to run underneath that bonus room to our exhaust point up there. And one thing to mention with our exhaust point is we've got to be at least 10 feet off the ground. We've got to be a foot above the roof when we go through the roof. And then any window within 10 feet, we've either got to be 2 feet above it or 10 feet away from it. In the fall, that's going to change to, if we're closer than 10 feet, it's going to change to 4 feet above the window. Right now it's 2 feet. So let's take a look in the garage and see how we jogged over here. Oh, and one thing to mention too, is even if we could get in that little knee wall, the bonus room, we wouldn't have been far enough away from either of these two windows. So that's another reason we jogged all the way over there. So here is the corner of the house, right here. And we've got the mechanical room on the other side of the wall here. So we came out under the stairs. We do have a fire stop collar to protect the house from a garage fire. Our pipe runs up and along, and it's pitched the whole way to allow any condensation or rain that gets in that pipe to drain back to our suction point. So we go all the way over to the third stall where we go up, and that's where our radon fan is. So we've got the Fantech RN4 installed right now. Currently it's pulling about 170 watts, and we should be able to dial everything back to make it more energy efficient and quieter once we finish up our ceiling in the basement. So now let's take a look at the basement portion of the radon system. So the first thing we want to do when we're engineering a radon system is drill our test holes that allow us to measure the negative pressure under the slab. We found the key to getting your levels really low is to engineer a system that creates suction under the entire basement. So if our suction point is in the mechanical room over there, it makes sense that our weakest spots are either going to be out in the middle here or on the far side of the house. In this instance, they happen to be in the office here. So we've got this carpet pulled back, and we drill a half inch hole through the slab. In this case, they have radiant heat in the floor. So we'll talk more about that in the boiler once we get in the mechanical room there and show you the boiler. But that means there's lines that run through the slab here, and we want to locate those before we drill our holes through the slab. So we use a thermal camera to do that. I think this one is called the FLIR 1, and it just plugs into your phone. You can go Android or iPhone adapter, and I think this is like 150 bucks or something like that. I bought it a few years ago. We'll put a link to it in the description. So we located here, drilled our test hole. With no suction, our test hole was reading, this one was reading positive 0.7, so that means the house was sucking radon in. And then we've got another test hole back under the stairs here. So this one was reading positive 0.2. So we had more soil gas entry from over there than we do here. And again, just a half inch hole through the slab. Currently we're reading about 22, 23 pascals negative on this one, and negative 9 over on that other one. So here in the mechanical room, we've got our suction point here where we came up, and then we turned and went out to the garage, and that's right where the steps are from the garage into the house. So we've still got to do some wrap up here, but here we've got our boiler. So this creates the heat for the radiant heat in the floor. And you can see over here, this is where all those lines go down, the supply and returns. And we got lucky in here because all the lines ran right under the furnace there. They did not run, you know, to the sides here where we had to worry about coring our hole there. So there's nothing in the way there. So before we did any sealing with just that radon fan cranked up to 10, we had -4 pascals in the office, and we had -11 pascals in that test hole under the step. So John and I had worked on sealing in here. We sealed the Florida wall joint, so we pulled up the poly and the insulation, and then we foamed that Florida wall joint. You could actually even hear a leak back there. So we sealed that, and then John sealed the cracks in the concrete floor and the control joints that we have here. And then sealing just that, that's where we're at currently, where we have -9 in the office and -23 under the steps. So our next step is to finish sealing under the stairway. So let's go ahead and see how we do that. So for prep work, what we did in here is I vacuumed under here anywhere where the sheetrock was touching the concrete and I couldn't get at that gap back there, the Florida wall joint. I used my Sawzall to cut that sheetrock up a little bit higher so that we could get under there to seal that. So it's all cleaned, prepped, ready to go. Next, I'm just going to foam that. We can also use radon sealant. We'll put a link to this in the description as well. But it's hard to get that under there unless you've got a big gap. So here, I think we're just gonna foam it. Got the Great Stuff Pro Gun with these tips. Work really good for getting in those tight spaces. So Tech has introduced this little e-cig thing, and it creates a stream of smoke and we can find air leaks with that. So it's the same company, Tech, as the Energy Conservatory. They're out of Minneapolis, same company that makes these awesome gauges for us. But when we puff that, you can see it pull that smoke down. This is the Florida wall joint here. So that's conditioned air being drawn from the house. So if we seal that, we can make the system more energy efficient. All right, so I finished the ceiling. One thing to mention while we're in here too is we do have the sump cover that John installed. Customer did opt for a water alarm too, which is a nice feature coming from a person that's basement's flooded. It's a very cheap insurance to have a water alarm. We did test the sump pump. It is working, so we are good to go. We got a check valve and then our access port. So as far as sealing goes, we did start at -23 before we sealed in here, and now we're at -28 on our gauge. And in the office, we are -10. So we didn't gain as much in the office, but in here, obviously, it helped a little bit. So from here, we're just gonna go dial in that radon fan because we don't need 28 and 10 pascals. We're looking for about 5 pascals negative in our weakest test hole. So that'll be our next step, and then we'll just have our cleanup. So I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. Thank you so much for watching.